Hello, my name is Darryl Swann with OTC DAIHEN, Inc., and thank you for joining me today as I introduce our new FD21 robot controller, a new generation of robotic control. We are here to answer any questions you may have throughout this session, so just comment in the live text chat and we'll be happy to help. So let's start off with some of the criteria that we had to consider when developing our new robot controller. Social issues, labor shortage, skilled worker age gap, increasing wages, caused medium-sized and large manufacturers to request for highly capable and connected robotic automation. We also heard from small and medium-sized manufacturers requesting to augment current manual operations via the addition of robotic automation. So these are two of the requests that add to the growing global automation needs. Responding to automation needs. Highly automated robotic systems create expectations, including the need for full turnkey systems, reaction to and demand of manual labor reduction, changing from a standalone single robot to a complete robot system. These expectations require us to become a robotics manufacturer with equipment that is easy to cooperate with system integrators' requirements. Content that we needed to strengthen, standardization of the latest safety functions, standardization of handling functions, easy to cooperate with other companies' peripheral equipment, various options that can be added by system integrators, improvement of basic robot performance, better functionality. The request to augment current manual operations with robotic automation. The market is expanding, but it has not been able to deliver products that meet its needs. Major customers in Indonesia, India, and Thailand have not expanded from Japanese-owned motorcycle and car manufacturers for 10 years. Japanese small to middle end users have decided that securing outside resources is better than introducing robots. Some of the issues: inconsistent cost effectiveness, robot not easy to operate or difficult to use, insufficient maintenance and support systems, etc. Other content that we needed to strengthen: lowering the barriers to robot implementation, easy operation, limit manual operation and less training, support for robot operation and maintenance on demand. Solutions with the FD21 controller. Being able to strengthen the content of advanced automation, standardization of the latest safety functions, standardization of handling functions, easy to cooperate with the other company's equipment, various operations that can be easily added by the system integrator, improvement of basic robot performance, along with being able to lower the hurdles of robot introduction with easy operation, realization of less instruction from manual operation and less training, support operations and maintenance in any time, and also answering questions, other questions from customers. Is safety improvements expensive? And can I use smartphones or other smart devices? Being able to implement these solutions will allow us to meet the growing automation needs with our new FD21 controller. Design goals of our new FD21 robot controller: enhance the system integration ability, provide a robot controller capable of meeting various field automation requirements, supporting both advanced automated production systems aimed at unmanned operations, or in some cases, lights out, advancement of system needs in Japan, Europe, the United States, and China, providing robots that system integrators can easily upgrade, along with promoting robotization in emerging countries, easy to install and easy to use robots with less manual operation and less training. Improved features of the new FD21 controller. In regards to system integration, high scalability, standardization of the latest safety functions, extensive cooperation with external devices and systems, improvement of basic robot performance. In regards to easy operation for the first-time users, new easy-to-use teach pendant, or TP, tablet-like interface, remote maintenance support. Just a reminder, we're here to answer any questions you may have throughout this session, so just comment in the live text chat and we'll be happy to help. So let's continue on. Let's discuss the improved features of the FD21 controller related to system integration. Larger, more expansive auxiliary access support. Compact implementation of required specifications. Additional access configuration with superior scalability. Independent two-axis controller, contributing to size and cost reduction. Up to 2 7-kilowatt motors can be controlled by this independent two-axis control unit. That's right, you did hear me say 7-kilowatt motors. We've increased our capacity of the external axis motors up to 7 kilowatts. Easy installation of this external axis module reduces installation by 60%. 5 controllers can be connected together. We've also provided a 25% reduction in the size of the FD21 controller, while still allowing to control up to 8 axes. High scalability, enhancing automation levels with free optional equipment combinations, increasing scalability, connecting optional equipment to enable a variety of combinations. Combinations are possible by serially connecting boards. In the previous model, limited number of combinations were allowed. There are combinations that cannot be constructed due to hardware limitations. Advanced safety functions. Advanced safety functions as standard equipment. Standardizing on safety requirements from major automotive customers. The robot monitoring unit function can now be easily added with a position monitoring board. This is a big improvement on installation time and complexity. Space-saving facilities can be constructed with RMU functions. For example, system using virtual safety fence capabilities. Industry 4.0 ready. OPC UA compatible. The robots required by our customers' production control systems can be easily processed. We can now support advanced automation such as Industry 4.0. Examples of internal robot information that can be monitored: robot operation, such as motor currents and temperatures, controller data, such as IO signals, application data, such as welding parameters. The ability to track and make smart choices about operational efficiency, production output, and system performance can now be outputted to the customer's factory network by the OPC UA response software PLC that's built in. The internal information to be monitored from the robot can be selected at the teach pendant. Offline programming generation from CAD/CAM. No longer necessary to divide the data generated from CAD/CAM. Capturing CAD drawings with FDST. You can generate task programs automatically. In FD11, there was the need to split programs and use the call program function. No longer is this necessary. This is due to the total memory capacity increase by 40 times, up to 10 gigabytes. FDST offline programming by Teach Pendant. Here's a short video that shows the ability to use the teach pendant with the FDST software. This feature could be very useful for virtual robot teaching without the physical robot and robot controller. Built-in PLC software. The workbench software by Isograph is now provided as a standard. This strongly supported developing PLC program can allow you to create and edit PLC software programs on your PC. Improvement of basic performance. Sixfold improvement in the accuracy of output signal position reproduction. High-speed precision machining is possible. For example, variation in position of condition change during laser welding high-speed operation is reduced. This allows for faster I/O response, less latency, better accuracy. Increased freedom in multiple robots. Extending the number of registered logical system configurations, what we call units, from 9 to 32. At the same time, 9 logical system configuration units can be started. This allows for less complex, easier, and faster robot programming when using multiple robots and external axes with coordinated motion. Laser processing. Equipped with standard interfaces from major laser oscillator manufacturers, IPG and Trump, setup is completed only by selecting the manufacturer. This provides large reduction in startup man hours. The interface can be easily extended by adding a definition file. Laser processing commands. Laser machining exclusive use commands are standard. For example, laser on-off, laser power control, and gas on-off. These functions provide optimal control of laser machining timing and robot operation for laser machining. Smart shape pre-program pattern. Automatic teaching of cutting programming. The basic cutting pattern program is automatically generated by one touch. Automatic programming with center position teaching and radius settings for arcs. Automatic programming including piercing. These standard functions are not application specific and can be used for other applications like plasma cutting. Support for third-party machine vision sensors, 2D and 3D. Machine vision guidance built-in. Discrete component location orientation detection of via 2D machining vision sensor. Bin picking of bulk components via 3D machine vision sensor. Built-in interface and programming commands with the FD21 robot controller. Built-in machine vision setup and commands. Built-in library of supported vision sensors with dedicated program commands. The communication setting is completed by only selecting the sensor. Cumbersome communication setup is not required. Visual sensors specific instructions can be used for imaging and receiving measured values. Complicated language programming is not required. Conveyor tracking with machine vision guidance. Automation of sorting and boxing operations that relied on people. Flow of work on the conveyor. Robotization of work sorting process. Continuous picking without stopping the conveyor. Automatic sorting by detecting non-defective and defective products. Our conveyor tracking has been upgraded with vision-guided locating, orienting, and sorting. Improved features of the FD21 controller. Easy operation for first-time users. The new and improved teach pendant. Easy to see, clear letters with increased transparency. Easy to press. Lighter press force with tactile click feedback. Raise features for blind touch programming. Easy to hold. 15% weight reduction compared with the FD11 teach pendant. Ergonomic shape for easy grip to reduce arm fatigue. Improved maintenance with a replaceable hook. Improvement of spatter resistance by changing the structure of the screen frame. Improve maintenance with the cable quick connect at both ends. Tablet-like teach pendant operations. Icon grid menu for phone-like operations. New teach pendant window with finer touch resolution and higher display resolution. An added function for automatically assigning buttons in descending order of usage, of frequency usage, is also provided. Touch panel only editing as an option to the conventional keypad. For full screen display for task programming editing, moving screens with the swipe of the finger, move the parameter directly to the cursor by touching it, and also the numerical entry with the 10 keypad. Shortcut access to home and menu screen. The addition of two exclusive use keys and projection increases workability. You can jump to a home or menu screen at any time. A blind touch can be made with the before mentioned key protrusions. Remote maintenance. Connect the robot controller to the service center via the network in case of trouble. Rapid support is available by connecting to the server. Our service technician connecting to the server, the customer connecting to the server, will allow us to perform the necessary maintenance operation by completely remote operation of the teach pendant. Remote teach pendant operation, remote backup, remote upgrade can now all be done without visiting the customer's facility. Here is a short video showing one of our technicians remoting in to the robot teach pendant. You can see the changing of the menus initiated by the technician. That completes my introduction of our new FD21 robot controller. Order now for 2021 delivery. Thanks again for joining me today. I hope you were able to take away some valuable information. If you have more questions or want to continue this conversation, join me in the post-show video chat for this segment. Hope to see you there. Have a great day.